Next thing we want to do is we want to take a look at the text editors that are on our VMS system. A necessary task that the system manager needs to perform is to edit files in order to configure or set preferences on the behavior of programs in the system. You may find it also useful to use text files to create scripts to accomplish commands you need to perform over and over again, or to document commands for future reference. On our computer-based training CD, there's a document entitled Surviving Open VMS, and in there, starting about page 10, is a section that discusses editors for Open VMS. Historically, there were two editors for Open VMS. One was called EDT, and the other one was called EVE or TPU. TPU stands for Text Processing Utility. TPU is the new, current, and default editor on VMS systems. However, because of the way systems evolved or because of the preferences of previous administrators of VMS in your site, you may be using the EDT editor instead. So I thought I'd take a couple of seconds to show you the two editors. Editors are one of those things that are frequently customized at each site, so the behavior of your editor may be slightly different than mine. With that caveat, if you type edit at the prompt, you may get either the EDT or the TPU editor. If in doubt, you can usually say edit slash and then the editor you want, EDT or TPU, and then a file name and start working. If you just hit return without typing in a file name, the system will prompt you for a file. It happens that there's a file in our directories called sample.txt that we can look at. And this is a file from a Py2 system that we can just type on and chop on here. By default, the editor comes up in stream editing mode. So you've got this star at the beginning of the line, and you see above it the first line of the file. In this mode, you can issue commands and process the line that you see on the screen, or you type C for change, and they'll take you into full screen mode. Okay, so this is the way the editor works. You can use the cursor keys to move up and down, and you move the cursor left and right to navigate through the file. If you wanted to quit what you're doing here, in the EDT editor, you press Control Z, and that takes you back to the prompt. And at this point, you can type exit to save your file, or quit. You have to spell it out to quit the file. To contrast this with the TPU editor, if I type edit slash TPU, it brings up this screen and it loads an empty file for me to work with. At this point, I can press the command key, more on the command key later, but trust me here, and I can say get file sample.txt, and that'll load this file up for me. The TPU editor, one characteristic of it is that it has a status line down here at the bottom of the screen, where the status line tells me, for instance, that if I'm typing text, I'm going to be inserting text as opposed to overwriting text, that my file is write enabled, and that if I'm going to search for text in the file, it's going to be searching in the forward direction. Okay. Just as before, I can use the cursor keys to move up and down through the file and left and right through the file, and I can press the command key to quit. For most of our discussion of editing and text processing in VMS, we're going to be using the TPU editor. So that's where we'll begin with the next lesson.